Let's turn to exploring the Shema discussions on the issues of Trinity. We are in section three or paper three, exploring the Shema, who or what is the Holy Spirit. And I know for a fact we're in the section on who or what is the Holy Spirit, who or what Spirit is indwelling believers, section three of my Shema study. So let's drop down into the study. We pulled a quote from the book of Galatians chapter 3 into the study. We're entertaining the discussion about who is inside of us as believers. Is it the Spirit of God? Is it the Spirit of Christ? Or is it the Holy Spirit himself? Now, it sounds like a somewhat of an absurd question from a Trinitarian perspective. Every well-meaning, established Trinitarian under the sound of my voice would answer my question as something like, Ariel, of course, all three are inside of us, but we don't have to think of it like three spirits, or four if you want to count your own spirit still living in there. It's not necessary that you want to think of God's Spirit as separate from the Spirit of Messiah, as separate from the Holy Spirit. There's only one Spirit, one person of the Holy Spirit, one third person of the Godhead or the Trinity, known as the Holy Spirit, and he dwells inside of us. But the language that the Bible offers to us helps us understand that it's the very same Spirit of God who is the Spirit of Messiah in a mysterious way. And the reason I brought this discussion in, where it's relevant for us in our Trinity study right now, is because when we're talking about salvation, can we say that God's Spirit dwells within us generically, and thus in a generic fashion, we don't really need the Spirit of Messiah to enter into discussion. Can we be saved by acknowledging God's Spirit alone? Can I just say, well, I'm a Jew, I'm a religious Jew, I believe in God, and I believe in God's Spirit, and I believe that if I keep the commandments, that God's Spirit comes to dwell on me and in me. Therefore, I'm saved and I'm on my way to heaven. Is that a valid discussion? I would say no. I would say no. Why? Because the exclusive claims that Jesus makes as Messiah include belief in his atonement as my Messiah. I must place my objective faith in his atoning work on the cross in order to receive the indwelling Holy Spirit that God sends and in order to claim genuine salvation. Well, that's true today because Christ has come. Christ has already been crucified. Of course, I can state that emphatically as a 21st century Christian. But could we state that for someone such as Abraham? Was Abraham saved the same way that I'm saved? Did he have the same Holy Spirit inside of him that I have inside of me today? I think the answer is yes. And we pulled a quote from Galatians chapter 3, where Paul goes to great length to explain to the Galatian believers there that Father Abraham is the man of faith that they need to model their faith after. Abraham was declared as genuinely saved by God because he placed his genuine trust in the word of the Lord who was revealing himself to Abraham. And indeed, we would even go on to believe from the book of Hebrews, that Abraham, or I'm sorry, even Yeshua's own words, that Abraham was even given a glimpse of Messiah's crucifixion. Abraham longed to see my day and he rejoiced. He was glad when he saw it. Jesus tells us, I think it's somewhere around John chapter 6 or 7 or 8 that he talks about that. So Paul brings Abraham in as the model of faith for Christian Gentiles in Galatia, right? And if Abraham is the model of faith, how could this be unless Abraham had the genuine gospel? These are the verses that you're seeing scroll by slowly on my screen from Galatians chapter 3. Galatians 3 verses 1 through 9. Go back and read them on your own. I'm not going to read them again for our study. Instead, let me pick up our quote here and go in this direction. I say in my notes, the gospel is plain and open to us right here in the Bible. I'm talking about Galatians chapter 3, which is nicely complemented, I might add, by Romans chapter 4. If you have some time this week, I highly recommend sit down. It doesn't take very long to read these two chapters. Sit down and read Galatians chapter 3, and then turn immediately to Romans chapter 4 and read that. Very nice complementary material where the same author, Paul, talking about the same biblical character, which is Abraham, and he's addressing a similar segment of people, which is Gentile Christians, to explain how that they, the Gentile Christians, have been brought into the family of Abraham by faith, the same way that Abraham was brought into the family of God, the same faith, the one and same gospel, the same Messiah as the object of their faith, the same Spirit indwelling them as genuine believers. And all of this is done, and then very important from Paul's day perspective, all of this is done without having to change their ethnicity from Gentile to Jew. So let's look at my notes. We'll be right back.